All right, I want to share this dream I had last night. Now, right before I went to sleep, I prayed and I asked God for some type of communication from him. I wanted to hear from him. I asked for a sign, like, show me something, God. I prayed that, but I prayed that, you know, just recently in the past too. I've been praying that God would reveal some things to me. So I went to sleep last night. And I woke up at 3 o'clock this morning. But right before I woke up, I had a dream that I was at some sort of ceremony where they was giving praise to Lil Wayne. He had came out with some song, and it was a nice song in the dream, and everybody was talking about it. They were just giving honor to Lil Wayne, right? And after that ceremony, I remember I was talking to some guy who I went to elementary school with, and we was talking about, you know, the song that Lil Wayne had came out with. It was a tight song, and we was talking about the greatest rappers and all that. So next thing you know, while we was talking, some events start happening, and some stuff started happening in the sky. It was some, like, dust just started pouring out of the sky. It's like some different times had come now. Dust started coming out the sky in, like, swirl pattern, different patterns. And it was scary, though. It was scary. And it's like I tried to shield my face from the dust so I wouldn't suffocate in it, so it wouldn't go in my face and suffocate me. And this man, and you know, this part is kind of difficult to explain, but all I know is I remember looking up, and it's like something like real high in the sky, like these different signs and wonders was happening. And it's like the end had came, and I remember walking, and remember it was me and like other people. We were just walking in, you know, in one direction, and this dust was steady coming down. And I remember I turned around trying to walk backwards to prevent the dust from getting in my face. And it's all kind of other unexplainable things that was happening. But when this stuff was happening, you had the feeling of fear. It was scary, like you knew that the end was, you know, had came, and you was going through this because it was God ordained to happen. Like, I remember all I could think of in this dream was, I hope this is a dream. I hope this is a dream. And the thing about it is, in that dream, I was like, man, this is not a dream. This is not a dream. And I was just hoping that I wake up because it was so scary, and I knew it was no turning back. It wasn't no coming back to this normal life like we have it as now, like we are now. It was never gonna change, you know, and you knew that this life wasn't coming back. And I just remember we was crying. I was crying in the dream because I was scared, and then I knew that all this happened because of, you know, we was disobedient, and we were just going through the wrath of God that was coming. And it's like unexplainable things that was happening in the sky, man. And it's very scary. But I'm pressing the issue with the wanting to wake up, because in that dream, I was so terrified. I just kept hoping, I hope this is just a dream. I hope it's just a dream. And in the dream, I was like, nah, this is not a dream, because I wasn't waking up. And I believe that God kept me in it long enough so that I know that once the end come and these different wonders and stuff start happening, you know what? How Jesus said in Matthew 24, how he said the stars will fall from heaven and, you know, and fall into the earth. That stuff was going on. That stuff was going on in a dream. And it was very scary because I knew it wasn't no turning back. It wasn't no coming back to this normal life. And I was so fearful. And I just want to share that with y'all, you know, because I had just prayed and asked God to show me a sign. See, and God allowed me to have these type of dreams before. But I never really took heed to them like I am now. But once the end come, you know it ain't no turning back. God gave me multiple dreams like this, and I got to share it with people because this is a warning for everybody. I have to tell y'all, man, you have to repent. Whatever you're doing in your life, sin is not worth being left behind. When Christ come back for his church and everybody else on the earth that's going to go through the wrath of God, it's not going to be no plan. It ain't going to be no turning back. And I'm going to tell you another thing I want to say too. Only thing you could think about when that happened is you and what you're going through. You're not going to think about your family. You're not going to think about no kids. You just fearful for what's going on with you at that moment. You don't even have a thought to think about your family. It's all you and everything you've been doing. Also, I want to add too, another part of that dream was after all these wonders was happening, these stars was falling from heaven, falling to the earth, the dust coming off, and that being scary, it went to a part to where people start to lay down on their stomachs. And I remember laying down on my stomach, and then somebody came, some sort of man came and just started beating people. And everybody was just screaming and you know, and it's like you couldn't fight back. Like fighting back wasn't even a thought that could come to your mind, because this was something that, you know, it wasn't like how it is today. If a man, he come and try to fight you today or beat on you today, you will fight back. But in that dream, in the end, everybody was just submitting to laying down, submitting to being beaten, just screaming. But before I got beat or anything, I didn't get beat because I woke up. And when I tell you this, once I finally woke up, man, it was a sigh of relief. I was thankful to God that it was only a dream, because I was just hoping it was only a dream. And in a dream, I was like, nah, this is not a dream, because it wasn't changing. And God kept me in that dream long enough to experience what it would be like to be left behind, to not be saved, you know, to be left for the wrath of God. And those are going to be some terrible times. So I encourage everyone, I want to share this dream with you. God allowed me to see it, experience it, and I just want to tell y'all, repent from all your sinful ways, turn to Jesus. This is no game. Oh yeah, and one more part I want to add is I believe that the part where, you know, where we was giving Lil Wayne praise about this song, I just believe that that means that people, we are idolizing celebrities, idolizing rappers and singers, and we focus on them instead of giving honor and praise to Jesus Christ. And that needs to change. Don't idolize these celebrities. And you know, we all on social media dancing to all their songs, giving them praise and honor and awards and shows. And I'm telling you, that's idol worship. That's idolizing them, and we should be idolizing God. God said he have no idols and no other gods before him. So when we giving these rappers and singers honor and praise for their songs and their music, we are putting them in the position that we need to put have God in. And that's honoring and praising him for all he's done. So I'll see you next time, next video.